So today we will discuss about the hex file, and this hex file is generated after writing a program in assembly language. The purpose of the hex file is to download this file in the microcontroller, then our microcontroller will perform the desired operation. So in this hex file, in this particular example, there are total 3 lines. And you can see this is line 1, this is line 2nd, and this is line 3rd. But in now total number of lines depend upon the program written by us. In some program you can find the lines maybe 4, in some you will find the lines maybe 5. But in this example we are having total 3 lines. So in this hexadecimal file you will find the characters and the decimal numbers, and these numbers are in hexadecimal. Now we will see each line starts with a colon. So here you can find this is a colon. So line always starts with a colon. After this we have to concentrate now on the next 2 digits. So here it is 10. As I told you, in hex file all the characters are in hexadecimal form. So in this example this 10 means 10H. This means this is a hexadecimal number, this is a hexadecimal number, and it is equivalent to 16 in decimal form. So this 10 indicates that in this particular line there are total 16 bytes. Maximum number of bytes in a line can be 16. There cannot be more than 16 bytes in a line. So in this example, in the first line, total number of bytes of our program will be 16. And what are those bytes, that we will discuss afterward. Now after this, now you concentrate on next 4 digits. In this example, we are having 0000. So this 0000, again this is in hexadecimal form. So these four digits indicate the address of our program code memory. Means whenever we will write a program, then we have to generate a hex file, and that hexadecimal numbers are to be loaded in program code memory of the microcontroller. So in the program code memory, at what address we are going to load our program, that will be given by these 4 digits. So these 4 digits tell us that the starting address of the first byte of this line. So first byte of this line will be loaded at address 0000H. Now concentrate on next 2 digits. Here in this example, these digits are 00. And this 00 indicates that this is not last line. One more line is there in our hex file. So as you can see, after 00, after this line, one more line is there. So this is about the total number of bytes in a line, the starting address of the first byte of a line, and whether there are more lines in the hex file or not. After this, first byte you will find. Now you can find here 75. This is first byte of this line. And this 75, this data 75, is stored at location 0000. So the first byte will be loaded at this address. Next byte is 89. This is the next byte, and it will be loaded at address 0001H. So in this manner we will finally going to load these bytes in the program code memory. So these are the addresses of program code memory. So finally here you can find in this line there are total 16 byte. 16 byte is this. A1 is the 16 byte. So 16 byte is A1 and this byte will be loaded at address 000FH. So in this manner all the 16 bytes can be loaded from starting address 0000H to 000FH. Now you can find here one more byte after the 16th byte. Here in this case it is 8B. So this 8B is checksum byte. So regarding the checksum byte, we will discuss afterward. So this is about the first line. Now we will go to second line. In second line, again considering our first two digits, as I told you, these first two digits will tell you total number of bytes in this line. So in this line, total bytes are 0, 8, which is equal to 10 in decimal. So in this second line, you will find total 10 bytes. Now, next four digits here 0010. This is the address of first byte of second line. As we have seen in the first line, the last address was in first line, last address was 000FH. So the first byte of second line will be on immediately next address, and next address will be definitely 0010H. So you can find this 0010 here. This is the address of first byte of the second line. Again after this 00, this indicates one more line will be there. This is not the last line. After this C2, this is the first byte. This is the first byte of second line, and this byte is stored at this address. At this address we have loaded C2. So immediately at the next address at 0011, we have next byte, which is 8E. So in this manner, last byte of this line is 12. So 12 is the last byte of this line, and this 12 will be loaded at 0019H at this address. And finally, after this 12, you will find another byte, and this is again checksum byte. Now we come to the last line. In the last line, first two digits will tell you total number of bytes in this line, and here it is 00. This means in this line there are no bytes. So since this is 00, so after this next four digits is not having any significance for this particular line. After this it is 01. So 01 indicates this is the last line of the hex file. After this it is FF. So FF is the default value of all the remaining memory locations. Means from 0000H up to 0019H, up to this location, we have loaded our program. And after this, means from 001A location, from this location, whatever locations are remaining in the program code memory, FF is the default value of that, those particular numbers.